Raiffeisen always felt that people had to be at the center of all political and social activities. His greatest talent was to provide a vision to people.
Amalia Raiffeisen
had an enormous task to master during her life.
We certainly strive for a more equitable society, also by means of cooperatives.
A cooperative is, per se, a democratic organization.
Many are able to achieve what one person can't.
The members of the association know each other and guarantee for each other. What one can't manage, many can. Don't they, Amalia?
I get asked time and again what he was like, how it all happened. He was born in 1818 and lived in eventful times, full of changes. Many people had to fight for their lives.
Man muss sich das Land damals völlig anders vorstellen, als es heute ist.
You have to see the countryside in a totally different light than today. The rural areas were poor, there were people who couldn't write or read. There were all kinds of dependencies in the country, and epidemics and famines. The supply of basic necessities was poor. It finally all built up to one big, big question. The rural question.
Der Landfrage.
He wanted to materially improve the lives of farmers, of the little people. Cooperation, solidarity, self-help. For him, that was the key.
Raiffeisen certainly didn't invent cooperatives. Cooperatives are the archetype of human cooperation, so to speak. But it was Raiffeisen's great achievement to bring this idea into modern times and turn it into such a practical form of rural cooperatives that they still work today. The cooperative is the optimal type of business when several people have a common goal or a common problem, and one person alone cannot achieve this goal or solve this problem. But together, they can. Everybody in a cooperative gets a vote, independent of his or her financial stake. A cooperative is a self-help organization, with self-responsibility of and self-governance by its members. The basic rule is one for all and all for one.
Der Winter 1846-47 war.
The winter of 1846-1847 saw the last big famine in Central Europe. And right during that winter, Raiffeisen found his great task. Raiffeisen undertook to procure grain from other parts of the Reich, found people to underwrite the loans he took out for that task, and founded the first cooperative association of its kind. The Bread Society of Weyerbusch.
Ersten Verein überhaupt, den Weyerbuscher Brotverein.
My father's Bread Society also built its own bakery, where bread was baked and sold. At 27, he became mayor of a desperately poor region in the German Westerwald, near Frankfurt and Cologne. That was in 1845, 1 year before I was born. At the same time, he started to grapple with the miserable situation of the people in this region. He couldn't bear to just sit and wait.
The farmers had not yet learned how to think as entrepreneurs, how to be successful on the market. They had to learn that, and that was a difficult task. There was a whole system of loan sharks with short-term, high-interest loans and credit lines. There were interest rates of 80%, unthinkable today. That way, these poor people were pushed further into dependency.
Raiffeisen
said, "We simply have to give the farmers affordable loans."
In 1866, we published Father's book on a system of credit unions.
The most essential responsibility of each member is his liability, the all for one and one for all liability.
Raiffeisen hat immer gesagt, meine
Raiffeisen always said that you have to be able to see the church steeple from the credit union.
Was für eine wunderbare Botschaft.
That's a wonderful message, actually, especially in these times of our current financial crisis, where no bank ever sees a church steeple anymore, and where the money is sent out into the big, wide world in hopes that it will carry interest, but instead never returns.
Ich bin eigentlich ein großer Freund der Konstruktion.
I am in fact a big fan of the concept of cooperatives. That has a lot to do with solidarity, with a collective. What convinces me most about this system, and what can be applied, I think, to a lot of situations in life, is the automatic stabilization which is created by the fact that the cooperative member is, at the same time, owner and customer of the cooperative. That means when the owner hurts the customer, they hurt themselves, and likewise when the customer hurts the owner. This system has, in fact, let's call it a self-stabilizer, which cannot be commonly found in capitalism.
Die man sonst im Kapitalismus nicht findet.
Denn mir scheinen Genossenschaften.
Cooperatives don't seem to be an alternative to the financial markets. They are, per se, too weak financially, and they sooner or later succumb to the very same rules and effects. But they seem to be an alternative within capitalism.
Im Kapitalismus darzustellen.
Cooperatives in general may probably have their best times still ahead.
Vorsicht.